On the program today, Egypt's central bank keeps interest rates unchanged. As part of our year-end review, we'll be taking a look at South Africa's economy, plus a look at how African farmers developed agriculture and tackled challenges in 2018. Thank you for joining us on Business Incorporated. I'm Chimezie Obi-Iwagu. We get the show started now with the markets, and it seems the bears have taking a grip on the Nigerian stock market, pulling the index down almost 2% at intraday. On the other hand, the JSE index was up 1.68%. Egypt is not trading today, but the market closed positive on Thursday. Kenya was marginally up on Thursday. And markets in the Middle East are already in weekend mode as the markets are closed on Friday. However, on Thursday, it was a bullish trading as Saudi Arabia and most other major Gulf stocks markets, buoyed by the sharp rebound on Wall Street overnight and Brent oil's recovery from below $50 a barrel. Saudi Arabia's index rose 0.50%, with all 14 petrochemical stocks rising. Saudi basic industries increased 0.4%. The Dubai index was up 0.03%, with developer Emma Properties climbing 2.6%, and Denmark Properties increasing 4.1%. Qatar's index rose 0.63%, with United Development adding 3.1% in heavy trade. Abu Dhabi's index was up 0.29%, with First Abu Dhabi Bank, the largest lender in the United Arab Emirates, dropping 1%. And in Europe, markets were higher on Friday morning following a wild session for stocks where the Dow erased a 600-point drop to close positive the previous day. On Friday marks the last trading day in the year for some global markets. Frankfurt Stock Exchange will be closed on Monday. But let's see how the year is winding down in Frankfurt with my colleague, Ulrich Bartz. Hello, Ulrich. Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us on the show. Well, Frankfurt is gearing up for an early closing to the year. Trading ends shortly at 2 p.m. your time. One would assume traders are happy that this year is finally over, aren't they?
I sure think they are, because it was such a disappointing year, much worse than most people expected. People here are gearing up for a little party when trading finally ends, and I hear that there will be some sparkling wine that will come out, and you will hear some corks popping, but it will be a totally different atmosphere than it was in the years before, when there was really something to celebrate. The DAX down about 20% for the year, and some of the major shares, worldwide names, or formerly so, one could almost say, basically tanking. If you look at the Deutsche Bank, it was once a powerhouse in the international financial world, but that's many years ago. And alone in this year, the share lost over 50%. The management looking for a viable business model with which to really earn the kind of money that it needs to earn in order to keep up with international competition. And there were so many issues that came up. I think traders are still reeling from this year as we speak.
And you have been talking to people all year. What would you say now? What really caught people off guard? What did they absolutely not see coming?
I mean, people knew what kind of a president there was in the White House, but I think the kind of trade conflict that Donald Trump escalated this year, and which one must be honest and one must be clear on this as well, the Chinese and the Europeans reacted to, just as reflexive. That took everybody by surprise that it went this far. And I think the gloom that emanated from that got worse and worse as the year wore on. So did Brexit. There wasn't the kind of estimation that there would be a no deal threatening at the end of this year. And then a third, but not the only issue, but a third major issue, I think the effect of rising rates in the United States. The Fed doing what it basically announced, but still the effect being viewed more seriously as the year wore on. And I think those are things that surprised the markets in the kind of dynamics and the kind of extent to which they influence the markets here.
So looking forward, is anyone optimistic about 2019 after such a gloomy 2018?
Not terribly optimistic. Most analysts see, for example, a DAX that is higher, a bit of a higher Wall Street. And they do see economic growth. That's the silver lining in all this. But people are going into 2019 a little shell-shocked. So the optimism is on a very low burner, if you will. People are hoping that it won't be like 2018. But I hear from some analysts or, for example, asset managers, only one of those things that I just mentioned, like the Brexit, like the trade war, like rates, has to go wrong, has to take on an even larger role in 2019 for it to spoil the year.
Well, Ulrich, I must say it's been a beautiful year with you and your team at DW. Let's do this again in 2019. I know this is the last for you for this year in the market. I wish you and everyone at DW a happy and prosperous new year. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you.
In Asia's rest of Asia rose on Friday, Japan solidified its first annual decline since 2011. Japanese stocks ended their trading year in negative territory on Friday as the Nikkei 225 slipped 0.31% to close at 20,014 points, while the topic shed 0.5%. Elsewhere in Asia, stocks mostly saw gains on Friday as the mainland Chinese markets closely watched in relation to the Sino-US trade war were higher on the day. The Shanghai Composite rose 0.44%, while the Shenzhen Composite gained 0.28% to finish its trading week at around 1,267. Now, over in South Korea, the KOSPI gained 0.62% to close at 2,041.04. Meanwhile, Hong Kong's Hang Seng Index was fractionally lower during its final hour of trade. The ASX 200 in Australia gained about 1.02% to close at 5,654 points.